guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited today because I have my friend Bianca here.
Hi.
She's a makeup artist. And we met a really long time ago, but we finally got to film for her channel today. This look that I'm wearing right now. And then she used some products that I really, really like. So I thought, why don't we film a video for my channel where we're talking about them and why they're good and, you know, for brown girls. I'm going to leave a link to that video down below so you can check it out. Make sure to check it out. And check out all her other videos. They're all really good.
Thank you.
Yeah, I love it. I want to talk about these because I freaking loved these.
They're amazing.
When I have other Glossier products that I really like, but I also didn't even know that they did makeup.
They're adding like a lot of makeup to their line. It's all very like skin oriented.
Okay, that's important.
So it's not like heavy, like crazy colors. It's just like to make, to like look natural.
Yeah, see, because normally like when I use the Benefit WhatsApp one like this, it's, I find it so heavy.
It is, actually.
Also, it's the wrong tone.
Which is weird for a highlighter because I feel like it should be
like
sheer.
Yeah, and you use both of them on me.
Yeah. So I did the darker one. I think that one's called, what is that one called?
Topaz.
And then I actually just put the lighter one on top.
Okay.
I did that because if you use like a darker one in a bigger area and then just put a little bit of a lighter one in the center, it just makes it pop more. Okay. Your skin look dewy without looking like shiny and like disco ball.
And overdone, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
So I really like that. I'm going to leave a link to these ones down below as well. I really, really, really like them. I really recommend them.
Best highlighter I've tried, and I've tried all of the highlighters.
I think they may be my new favorite highlighter. I also was asking her when she was doing my makeup, I was asking her about this. So this is a Stila blush palette, cream blush palette.
Clean blush and lip.
Okay, so you can use that as well.
Yeah.
But you said they don't make this anymore.
I don't believe so. They may, but I'm not 100% sure. I got a limited edition, but I was saying there's like a million brands that make cream and lip products.
Okay.
This one's just better for me because like I keep it in my kit and I use all different colors. I don't know if everyone would need that many.
And so which ones did you use on me?
So I mixed that color there.
Okay.
With that kind of like brownie tone.
Mm-hmm.
I usually mix everything, but I wanted to get like the neutralness of that with just a bit of a pop.
On my cheeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, I use it on your lips too.
Oh, okay.
I just put a gloss over.
I really, really like them.
Yeah.
Hard to find blush for brown skin, I find.
Yeah.
And people are always asking me that, and I'm like, oh my god, I don't know. Because I don't wear blush on my own.
Well, I feel like when I used to work for, like at a counter, everybody would come into MAC and every brown girl or black girl would be like, okay, I just need Raisin. And I'm like, you know, there's like 5,000 of them.
Yeah, I need
they
to
always
have
the same one. So that's good. Like you said, it's like, it's not easy to find. So.
Yeah, and then what other products do you think, like what other brands have products like that?
Makeup Forever has a ton. And like I said, mixing is really good.
Okay.
MAC does have a lot of cream blushes that are really nice.
Do they really? I don't think I've even ever seen
they do.
Blushes.
They do. Nobody pays attention to them, but they do have a lot
okay.
of colors.
Okay, good to
know. I feel like every brand has them now, so you just have to check it out and see what works for you.
Okay. Yeah, because I think I have a Revlon one that I really like that my friend recommended. I'm not a cream blush person because I feel like it's so much to make sure you like blend it properly in the right place. But I feel like that relationship between like your highlighter, your blush, and your bronzer, like if you mess that up.
The relationship.
I just feel like it's important.
It's called the sandwich. So highlight,
oh,
blush, contour.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have thought of that.
Yeah.
I think it's so important, and I feel like if you screw that up with your blush, then you just look ridiculous. That's why.
Well, yeah, you have to make sure you're blending it properly and that it doesn't start looking muddy and like dirt on your face.
Yeah. That's why I'm like so like reluctant
just
to
like
blush.
Just like build. Don't go in with a lot of product. Just do a little bit and then continuously build.
Okay. Good to know.
You're good.
Tips from Bianca.
Yeah.
Last but not least, I really like this one. I like Camino Pond too, but it's like a little out of my price range.
It's very expensive.
So I don't get it because I don't wear makeup that much.
But here's the thing.
I like this one.
Here's the thing. I've had that for like 3 years.
Really?
And it's nowhere near even the halfway point because you need so little.
Okay. It's heavy duty.
It's worth the money because it's such a good concealer. You only need like very, very little
mm-hmm.
and it's going to last you way longer. It's better to get something that's like better quality that'll last you longer than using something that's just going to like pull apart or whatever.
But is it okay to have a product for that long?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's fine.
You don't use the crap out of it, right?
Yeah.
And why do you think this concealer is good for women with like darker skin tones?
They just have a good variety of colors. There's a nice like peachy undertone, which is really good for like blocking out darkness around the mouth and under the eyes, which is usually the areas that darker skin has to cover.
Okay.
A good variety of skin color, and they cover really well.
And so are we supposed to wear warm tones or cool tones? Because people tell me two different things.
Depends on the person. So like,
so
it and it depends on the area of the face. So like around here, you need something more warm and under the eyes, and then everywhere else I use something very yellow.
Okay. That counts as cool?
Yes.
Okay. People at MAC tell me different things every time I go.
MAC has a different system, so they do
okay.
They do the opposite of what everyone else does.
Why?
I have no idea. That's just the way they've done it. So like cool and warm is the opposite of everything else, like everywhere else at MAC.
Okay.
So it gets a little confusing.
Weird.
Just get that one.
Okay.
Skin enhancer, I know.
It says sensual skin enhancer.
And it's just SX18 is the color.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Good to know. So if you have a skin tone like mine, get that one. And it'll last you 3 years.
I mean, it lasts me, I've had it for a long time. I mean, it depends how much you use it.
Well, you're a makeup artist and it lasts a long time.
Yeah.
I'm saying a lot. Okay, awesome. Great. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you.
Don't forget to check out the video that we did for her channel down below, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.